G'day, I'm Warwick Schiller and I want to talk about something that I see quite a bit that people are doing with their horses, and they're trying to actually solve a problem, but they're actually causing the problem to be much worse than it probably was in the first place. And the thing that they're doing is when people hold on to the lead rope, and they're always putting pressure on the lead rope, and they carry their arms stiff out to the side like this. Now, if you think about horses in a herd situation, their sense of security from a herd does not come from the physicality of the herd, like we're going to beat up the bad guys. It comes from the awareness of the herd. So I can stay over here and relax, because if something from approaches from that side of the herd, those horses will notice it and their energy will come up, and that energy will ripple through the herd and I'll feel it and off we can go. And if you think about that, horses aren't vocal. Horses don't go, hey, there's a bad guy coming. You know, they don't whinny to the other side of the herd. You know, they're silent communicators, that way they communicate a lot with energy. And what we have to realize is they really read our energy. And so when I see people holding onto a horse like that, the person's energy is usually in a very defensive energy, like I'm worried about getting hurt here, and their arms real stiff. So that their energy is saying there is something scary in this environment. Okay, I'm in panic mode. There's something scary in this environment that I'm worried about. And the horse feeds off that energy. Does that make sense there? So that's part of that. And then the other part of it is they're always hanging onto that lead rope and putting pressure on that horse's head. And when a horse can't make pressure go away, no matter what they do, because they pull it on the head when the horse is standing still, they pull it on the horn when the horse is moving around. If the horse can't make pressure go away, that tends to make them anxious too. And so you tend to see both of those things going on. And I just recently did a clinic where there was, I think almost every single horse there that was anxious and couldn't stand still had someone trying to make them stand still. And what you have to understand with horses is you don't control the horse. You have to control you. And when you can control you, then the horse can figure out how to control themselves. But there was everybody there, I would say, so let go of that lead rope. So drop that. You don't need to hang on to that. And they'd let it go, and I'd be talking to them. And while we were talking, they would reach out and grab it again. And I would say, what are you doing with your right arm? And they'd go, oh. They didn't even realize they did it. Now, I said before, horses are very, you know, their sense of security comes from the sense of awareness of the herd. And not just the awareness, the herd's awareness of what's going on, but awareness of self, especially with humans. And so if you have got a right arm that reaches out and pulls on the lead rope without you knowing that it's doing it, the horse knows that you don't know what your body's doing, which means you are no help to me. In case there was a saber-toothed tiger around here, you can't even control yourself. How the hell could you help me keep an eye on the surroundings? And so, you know, the first thing I usually do with horses like that is turn loose of them. And you're probably thinking, well, but what if he runs away? And so if you think about, horses will tend to go towards where their thoughts are, okay? And a lot of times you see people pull on the lead rope and the horse is dragging them around. Even though there's quite a bit of pressure on that lead rope, their thoughts are going over there. Their thoughts didn't come where the lead rope goes. And what I've got some videos I put on here from different horse expos and stuff, me doing this, but what I will do, if the horse gets to the end of the lead rope, as it feels the pressure, that slack coming out of that lead rope, I'll usually take my flag and just wave it towards their hind end to attract their attention. And so if you think about it, you're training them, you're training their thoughts to follow the lead rope. There's a little feel in the lead rope, then the flag attracts their attention, then the pressure goes away on the lead rope. And you do that and that, and after a while you can pick up on the lead rope and their thoughts come towards it. But you cannot do it if you're always pulling on that lead rope. And so if you think about, there's three things that happens when you do this right here. One is you're scared and your energy, you've got bad juju, you've got negative energy, you've got worried energy, which worries the horse. Then the horse would like to move their feet, and then you try to stop them from moving their feet. So there's those two things too. And then that makes them more claustrophobic. And the third part of it is you're wearing out your communication with this lead rope. I mean, I usually hold the lead rope in one hand, and if I want to do something with the horse, I will reach down the lead rope, pick up that lead rope, do something with it, and then drop this lead rope here again. And there's a at that clinic I was talking about recently, there was a horse there that the first day was like that, just dragging the lady all over the place, and the lead rope really didn't mean anything. And he was also quite pushy too, like really wanted to run over us. But by the second day, we could have him standing away from us, but I could just reach down the lead rope and pick up on it softly and subtly and send him off around me just by following the feel of that lead rope. But I had to restore some of that feel back in there because a lot of it had gone away just from, the hanging on the head and having that energy. And it's hard because none of those people who are doing that are actually, you know, they're not actually going, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to do everything wrong so my horse gets more nervous. They're actually trying to save themselves. But, you know, it's a little bit like if you get into a skid in a car, what you will tend to do is look at the thing you don't want to hit. And if you've ever taken a defensive driving course, they will teach you to look where you want to go, not where you don't want to go. And our first response tends to be looking at, thinking about all the things you don't want to happen instead of thinking about the things you do want to happen. So, you know, being around horses is really learning about to control your thoughts, control your energy, and control your physical movements. And if you can control those, usually it helps the horse a great deal. But if you cannot control those things, just those things in themselves are usually probably going to make those horses a whole lot worse.